We bring in the one and only Mike Wilbon in the house. Mike Wilbon, we know how this all came about. What happened with James Harden in Houston? Came into camp, skipped training camp, came into the season out of shape. We know he could drop 20 in his sleep, let alone 40, and he was averaging like 17 a game. Thinking back to those times while he was in Houston before he got traded to the Brooklyn Nets, what did you make of it then? What do you make of it now?
I don't know that it's changed, Stephen A. There's a word we used to use all the time, cheesy. That's what it was. It was less than. It was less than the James Harden that we had seen take Houston deep into the playoffs.
Is the audio
less than
be
the James
like
Harden who had been an MVP. Okay. It was just cheesy all the way around, especially
cheesy.
Now the way he pops up the other side in Brooklyn being, let's face it, either one or two on everybody's MVP list where it sits now.
Cheesy, I don't know how we look at that word in the year 2021, Mike Wilbon. I don't understand why you would use that word cheesy as extensive as your vocabulary is, but I'll let it go. Having said all of that, where do you have him right now when we talk about James Harden as an MVP? Where is he on your list at this particular moment in time, Wilbon?
By the way, Stephen, you know what cheesy is. When you frown and scrunch your face all up and say, no, man, I know this dude is better than that. That's cheesy. I have him too. But he's gaining on LeBron, it seems like, every day. And I've had LeBron won the whole season. James Harden is right there, the way he has just changed his game to fit exactly what Brooklyn needs on a nightly basis, particularly becoming the point guard. It's stunning and impressive every single game he walks on the floor.
You have James Harden, too. You have him inching up on LeBron James. I didn't hear the name Joel Embiid in that. We bring back in Mike Wilbon. Mike Wilbon, you know what time it is. This matchup tonight, Steph Curry versus Damian Lillard. Big-time matchup for me. Big-time matchup for you. Looking at them this year, who do you believe has had the better season?
Oh, goodness. Stephen A., I'm not going to try to separate those two because if there's a category of players I would pay to watch, if I take LeBron James and set him over here because he's in a category all by himself in so many ways, the next guys, the guys I'm putting my money down to see are Steph and Dame, Dame and Steph. You take one, I'll take the other. This season, I mean, if you go past seasons, you're going to take Curry because he won championships. But right now, where they are, and Curry's playing on better teams, Dame, Steph, Steph, Dame. You going to tell me you can choose between
Kyrie
the two
Irving?
Of them?
No Kyrie Irving in terms of watching
the
show?
Stephen A., he'd be right after that, right after those two. But I'm taking either one of those two first to pay to see. Hey, Kyrie, I don't know if he's going to play that night. I don't know if he's going to show. Those two guys are going to post.
When you talk about box office, we're assuming they're going to show, Wilbon. We're assuming they're going to show if you're talking about box office.
How many games he missed? Tell me again. How many games he missed, Kyrie?
12. I think it's 12.
Okay. Put your money down and don't have the show. See how you feel.
Wilbon, let's go back to you. When you look at the Brooklyn Nets, what's the biggest question you want answered about this franchise right now?
Can they play as the target, Stephen A.? You know they can play. I'm over the stuff about defense. They can play well enough defensively when they need to. I'm over the thing about depth. They have enough depth on that roster. We've seen it from game to game. But the question is, when targeted, they're going to be the hunted every single game for the rest of this season. How are they going to fare? I'm not taking a position on it yet. I want to see it. I believe what James Harden said, that when KD comes back, if he comes back fully healthy, oh, my goodness. But how are they going to play when everybody's gunning for them every night the rest of the way?
Oh, I got to talk to you later on. We got to get together. Only thing I'm worried about with them is injuries. If they're healthy, I ain't worried about them being a hunted. You got KD. What's wrong with you, Mike Wilbon? We're going to have this conversation for dinner. We're going to have this conversation. But you know what's up next, Mike? Oh, no, you did it. Stay right there, Mike Wilbon. Oh, no, you did it. You know what time it is. Let's go to number 5 on the list. Look at Carmelo Anthony. LaMelo Ball hugging one another before they went at each other the other night. LaMelo Ball pulls up from 30. Morning. But guess what? Melo, the real Melo, he's got an answer and one right there. You're talking about LaMelo Ball coming back down. Look at Carmelo right there. Oh, excuse me, he's 36 years of age. LeBron ain't the only 36-year-old that can play. Oh, no, you didn't, LaMelo Ball. Think that you was gonna take over being a real Melo. Oh no, you didn't. Not yet. Let's go to number four on the list, Jordan Clarkson. Check out this spin move right here. Look at this. Watch this move. Ooh. I mean, shook him with his pants. Put him on the floor. That's just embarrassing right now. Michael Carter Williams, what's going on, bro? I mean, you okay? Are you all right? I just want to know, because that was kind of embarrassing. Oh no, you didn't, Jordan Clarkson. Do that to that man. About to win Sixth Man of the Year award. Oh, no, you didn't. Way to go, my man. Utah handling their business, but so is that kid. That's a big reason why. Number three on the list. I don't even know how to pronounce this dude's name right here. I mean, what is it? Fiondu Kabengele? Kabengele. I don't know how to pronounce it. Hits the three. Everyone on the Clippers bench celebrating. It's like an equipment manager or a ball boy hitting the three for doing a game, for crying out loud. But that is what happened. Showing the support and love for, except Kawhi Leonard. Look at him. Mr. Darth Vader himself. Let's go to number two on the list. Hawks and Thunder. Jerseys. Look at this right here, ladies and gentlemen. Who did this? How is it that you got red and orange on the court at the same time? Who made that mistake? Ultimately, Oklahoma City's got to go in the locker room, change their uniforms to white, because you can't have them at the Hawks, and the Hawks showed up on the road with the wrong colored uniforms. As if they ain't got enough problems in Atlanta, you gonna do something like that. Oh, no, y'all didn't do that. No, y'all didn't. Number one, nothing beats this, ladies and gentlemen. Watch this right here. The game's on the line. It's a 4-on-1 break against the Wizards. Jamal Murray's got the ball, and nobody for the Nuggets goes to the basket. Nobody. Look at this right here. Everybody's up. I mean, just a pass, uncontested, to the basket. And nobody went to the basket. No, y'all didn't. Make such a boneheaded play like that. No, you didn't. And if you're Jamal Murray, you shoot the three. You don't give it to somebody else to do that. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.